Welcome to my channel MK MediGuide Lectures, learning with artworks like drawing and calligraphy.
In this video lecture, we will talk about the autonomic nervous system generally. Well, our nervous system is basically divided into two divisions. The central nervous system, consisting of brain and spinal cord, and the peripheral nervous system, which consisting of all neurons outside the central nervous system. This peripheral nervous system is generally divided into somatic nervous system and autonomic nervous system. The somatic nervous system is concerned with the voluntary movements of our body and innervate the skeletal muscles of our body. On the other hand, we have the autonomic nervous system, about what we are going to discuss briefly. Well, the word autonomic is derived from two Greek words. Auto means self and nomic means law. So, the autonomic nervous system is part of the peripheral nervous system that functions autonomously, mean independently and continuously, right? Without the conscious control, mean on this system we don't have control over. Autonomic nervous system is mainly concerned with regulation of visceral or vegetative functions of the body. So, it is also called vegetative or involuntary nervous system. Although stimulation does not occur voluntarily, but the individual may be conscious of its effects. For example, an increase in heart rate, as you may feel it sometimes, right? The autonomic pathway includes the central nervous system, afferent or sensory neurons, and efferent or motor neurons. The autonomic nervous system is stimulated by the sensory neurons, which conduct signals to the CNS from receptors in the viscera in the skin. Axons conduct these signals to centers in the brain or spinal cord. In response, after processing, motor impulses travel out from these centers on axons in cranial and spinal nerves. These axons typically lead to ganglia, where the impulses is handed to a second neuron which terminate into the target organ. Major parts of our nervous system controlling the autonomic functions is the hypothalamus and brainstem, where most of the autonomic centers are present. With addition, some functions are regulated by the spinal cord. The autonomic nervous system consists of motor portions of some cranial nerves from the brain, generally from the brain stem, and spinal nerves from the spinal cord. This is the brain stem and spinal cord that I have drawn here. And the autonomic neurons actually arise from here. The motor neurons of autonomic nervous system innervate smooth muscle, cardiac muscles, and glands of our body. For example, the effects of autonomic stimulation include innervating the heart leads to changes in heart and pores of the heartbeat. Stimulation or depression of secretion of glands like that of gastric, pancreatic, adrenal and lacrimal glands. Blood vessels constriction or dilation, bronchoconstriction or bronchodilation. changes in the size of the pupils of the eyes, energy metabolism, particularly in liver and skeletal muscles. Generally, an autonomic pathway from the central nervous system to a visceral effector consists of two motor neurons that sign off and a ganglion outside the CNS. The first neuron is called the preganglionic neuron from the CNS to the ganglion, which is myelinated. The second neuron is called the postganglionic neuron from the ganglion to the visceral effector, which is unmyelinated. The ganglia are actually the cell bodies of the postganglionic neurons. After this, the autonomic nervous system includes mainly two divisions, the sympathetic and the parasympathetic divisions. Some effectors are innervated by axons from each division. For example, heart, eyes, urinary bladder, genitalia, liver, and stomach. In such cases, these two divisions may act antagonistically and impulses on one set of axons may activate an organ while impulses on the other set inhibit it. In contrast, most blood vessels, spleen, sweat glands, and hair follicles receive only sympathetic neurons, while ciliary muscle, bronchial smooth muscle, gastric, and pancreatic glands receive only parasympathetic innervation. The sympathetic division prepares the body for energy expending, stressful or emergency situations. It's part of the fight, flight, or fright response. Conversely, the parasympathetic division is most active under ordinary restful conditions, in otherwise known as the rest and digest response. It also counterbalances the effects of the sympathetic division and restores the body to a resting state following a stressful experience. For example, during an emergency, the sympathetic division increases the heart rate. Following the emergency, the parasympathetic division decreases the heart rate. And with this, thanks for watching and support us by subscribing to our channel.